y'all. Sofa Tsapa here. Today is June 26, 2014. One of the subscribers was watching another video and he said, "Hey man, why don't you make some Cuban sandwiches?" So after much research, I'm going to make a makeshift Cuban sandwich, okay? It's not authentic at all, okay? It's not traditional at all, alrighty? Just to let you know, this is a makeshift Cuban sandwich, Surfing Sapo's style. Alright, let's get started. Alright, here's our hoagie, poor boy, submarine sandwich bun. We're going to take some mustard, just plain old mustard, and put some on there. Just a little bit, don't worry about it. I'm at the bottom of the barrel. Alright. Just spread it around best you can. Don't worry about it, folks. Just a little bit of mustard. Mustard. Alright. Get you some ham. Lay some ham on there. Don't worry about it. Just put it on there. It's not traditional. It's a makeshift sandwich. Nothing biggie. No biggie. It's a sandwich you eat. Alright. Get you some cheese. Three for good measure. Alright. Get you a couple of these sandwich sliced pickles. Dill pickles. Lay them on there. What this is just some pork I made, little pieces of pork, just lay them in there, like that, see, it's not pulled pork, it's just pork. Alright, there's our sandwich. Now we're going to lay this on top and take it over there, and we're going to make it like a grilled cheese sandwich on a frying pan. That's all I have. Okay, so we got this little frying pan here. I'm just going to get the butter everywhere. We're going to lay the sandwich in there. A little piece of meat fell on. I'll eat that now. We're just going to hold it down. No biggie. Butter get on everything. I'm going to take another pan and just set it on top. Kind of hold it down. Turn the fire up a little bit. Kind of like squeezing it. Yeah, it's pushed down pretty good. Okay. Let that go for a little bit. See what we got. Shouldn't be toasted yet, but it should be close. That's a little bit toasted. Okay, let me put some more butter. Okay, flip her over, do the other side, same thing, twirl it around, let it get to know each other, push it down, shut up, little dog picking on the old dog, you know how it is, the bully syndrome. Alright, that should be good. Let's see what we got. Oh yeah, toasty. Do the other side again. You get it nice and crunchy. Grill it down. To me it's like a muffaletta, but with just different stuff and different shape. No biggie. Alright, to me that'll do it. Take her out, set her over here, see what we got. Alright, hold on. Alright, there it is. Just sit out. And we're going to cut it. And cut it diagonally. Okay, so let me get it over here by the edge. Diagonally means like this, like an angle. Okay. There you go. Had a little hard time there. Okay, see what we got. There we go. Got the cheese, the mustard, the ham, the cheese, the pickle, the pork, a little bit more ham and mustard. So that's it. All we gotta do is taste test it, and I could already tell it's gonna be good. So let me turn the camera around, we'll get after that. Okay, folks, we're done. Here's our Cuban sandwich. You could tell, very beautiful. Everything's in there. Just take a bite out of the side right here. Oh man, that's really good. It's like a ham and cheese sandwich with pickles and pork. Go figure. Man, that's really good. That is really, really good, man. I wonder why I never ever thought about making those before. That's what friends are for, bro. Thanks for requesting it. Appreciate it, man. It's real easy, too. Super easy. The hardest part is making the pork. But if you could, when you do your pork, barbecue pulled pork, instead of shredding it all, just slice a couple pieces off. Keep it to the side for your Cuban sandwich, let's say. Alright? Well, thanks for watching, everybody. Subscribe, comment, like, or don't do any of those. It's up to you, folks. Alright, thanks a lot. Have a good day. God bless you. Bye-bye.